Hi there, and welcome back to Typical Books, where today we're going to talk about some of the things I've been reading recently, some of the things that have shown up on the doorstep, and what I'm going to be reading next month, like Keeper of the Key by Nicole Wilson, among other things. So, of course, you can see I'm reading You Like It Darker by Stephen King. This is something that I meant to read with my friend Amy Jane Vosper from Creep County Cinema, and I just didn't get around to it till now. It wasn't purchased for me till now, and I was too lazy, I guess, to go and buy it myself. I hadn't been in a real brick and mortar bookstore for quite some time outside of thrift stores or the library book sales. My loving husband did pick this up for me. For a bookmark, I'm using a beer label. We don't really drink, so it's rare that we have anything like this, but he'd also brought back some Yingling Lager, the Oktoberfest seasonal beer. And the label is making a really fitting bookmark. Not only because of the oranginess of this, there is somebody who used to drink in this, which is very common for later on Stephen King books, people struggling with past addictions. And it's getting close to spooky season, so an Oktoberfest label certainly fits. I'm absolutely loving this, and for those people that are saying this might be his best short story collection ever or yet or since Skeleton Crew, they're not wrong. And of course, Clown in a Cornfield 3, The Church of Frendo. This is something I had pre-ordered, very excited to get to, and I'm maybe going to read it closer to October, but I really just want to read it. I've got other reading. We'll see how that goes, especially considering there was a challenge that caught my eye. The challenge, of course, is on a lot of people's tongues right now. It's that Shorty November or whatever. Even though I won't really participate, it did remind me that I've got some short books to get to, and some that were bought for me alongside this book. And Schrader's Cord, Ollie read it over at Kim and Ollie, and that's the only other place I've ever seen it. But the idea really spoke to me. After his estranged father's mysterious death, Charlie Remick returns to Seattle to help with the funeral. There he discovers his father left him two parting gifts, the keys to the family record store, nice, and a strange black case containing four antique records that, according to legend, can open a gate to the land of the dead. Very, very perfect for me. I don't know why I had not heard of this earlier. I don't know where this book came from, and I just shocked I hadn't heard of it before. So I'm very excited to get to it, even though I have a lot of other reading to get to first. If you've read this, let me know. So as mentioned, I'm going to be reading Midwestern Gothic by Scott Thomas. That's a review copy that I've already read, but I'm going to like brush up my review because it does have a release date coming up, as does Keeper of the Key by Nicole Wilson, which is on my reading list. I'm going away for a little couple days, but that will be my evening reading during that, and I'll write up my review then. But this Shorty November, I think it's called Shorty November. The prompts are interesting, and I will leave them below, even though I'm not really going to be fulfilling, so I'm not going to like to title this video as a reading list or TBR for Shorty September, but it did remind me there's a lot of short books, and some of these short books just came into my possession, and I'm very excited to get to them. They don't seem very long, but Thorns in My Heart by D.L. Tillery is a poetry book. I've read most of it already, but I'm going to read it again cover to cover to kick off this short book extravaganza. Then The Tales of Beetle the Bard, which I'd mentioned in my last video. Acts of Violence by Marcus Hawk. It's a little longer than most of the other books here because it's a little more dense. It packs a lot into these pages, but I've been excited to get to it. I've had it sitting here a little bit, so I'm going to get to that over the next month or so. And Move Underground by Nick Mamatas. I picked this up a year ago, quite literally. So it's about time I get to that. And the last two that just came to me, T. Kingfisher books. I thought these were full-on big giant novels. I don't know why I thought that. Maybe I've not watched people do reviews and hold the physical book up. What Moves the Dead, What Feasts at Night, T. Kingfisher, based on House of Usher stuff. I liked the synopsis. I've seen mixed reviews, but I also didn't know how thin they were, so I'm going to take a chance on this. If you're a big T. Kingfisher fan, let me know. If you've read these, don't spoil them. Just, yeah, let me know what you thought. I love the design of these books. They've been on my list of books coming out because I love the covers. I don't know much about the author. I don't know much about the stories, except that it's vaguely something to do with the House of Usher. So I'm very excited to get to all of this, and such gorgeous covers on almost all those, especially Schrader's Cord. I just finished reading The Heads Will Roll, so if you've not seen it already, I do have a review up for that. And coming up next, there will be a nice list of books coming out for spooky season. Thank you ever so much for watching, and have an ooky spooky day.